Onshape's sheet metal tools enable you to design and create all the necessary information required for manufacturing. The standard hole feature now allows you to add counterbored and countersunk holes to active sheet metal parts. This means you no longer need to finish the sheet metal parts first before adding such features. And more importantly, the holes are represented in the flat pattern ready for detailing. When adding chamfers, you can select as many edges or faces as you need all in one feature. However, if you are adding asymmetric chamfers, i.e. not 45 degrees, then sometimes Onshape takes a guess at your design intent. So on this side, it looks all good, but on the other side, not so. Now, you no longer need to remove the offending chamfers and create them in another feature. You can simply add the edges to the Direction Overrides selection tool. Now, all chamfers with the same size can be created all in one feature. Another option in the chamfer feature is the measurement type. The default is offset, which is the usual way a chamfer size is calculated. But for edges that intersect non-planar faces, the result can sometimes be too severe. A new option, tangent, measures from the intersection of the tangent of the two adjacent faces. The result in this case looks subtle, but it may be more suitable for your needs. When sweeping a profile along a 3D path, you don't have any control over the profile orientation. In order to create the sweep and keep the profile normal to the path at all times, Onshape has introduced some twist, which is not what we want in this case. You can select Keep Profile Orientation, which removes any twist completely, but now the cross section isn't constant along the path. Now there are two new options: Lock Profile Direction, which is looking for anything that defines an axis, like an edge, plane, or hole, and now the sweep follows the path normal, but keeps the profile pointing in the right direction. And Lock Profile Faces, which will take any surface as input and adjust the orientation of the profile by calculating the vectors between the path and the selected lock faces. Cropped views are useful for detailing smaller areas of interest on larger parts and assemblies. Now, cropped views can also be sectioned to add detail to any internal features. In an assembly drawing, you have effectively removed the parts behind, so the default section type is set to show cut geometry only. You can, of course, edit this before or after creating the section view. Comments are great for gathering feedback from multiple sources and recording events and decisions made during the lifetime of a project. However, as projects get more complex, comments made on different branches and different versions can be easy to overlook, with only the original email notification being proof that a comment exists. Now, in the comments panel, a new filter enables you to view only the comments from the current workspace or version, or for the entire document. Each comment is tagged with the name of the branch or the version from where it was made, and you can even reply to comments without having to open the original source branch or version. These comments are live, so if somebody resolves or replies to a comment, you can see it here in real time. If there are a lot of comments, you can use the existing filter to show only the comments that interest you. And if new comments are added, you'll see them immediately. If an entity has been tagged in another workspace, the link will take you there directly. Or you can navigate the document using the Versions and History panel.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.